Hi guys, this is Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. Welcome back. This is the second part of our Build a One-Page Scrolling Bootstrap website. In the last part, we showed you where to download all the files for this one-page scrolling site that we've got here. So let's have a quick look at what we've got here. We've got a CSS folder. That's where all our CSS is going on. That's the default CSS. For those of you that don't know, CSS cascading style sheets are what is used to actually style the site, as the word says, you know, the padding, the color, the size of the font, etc. And that's the default Bootstrap here, and that's a minified version of it there, which means it just loads quicker. Here's the file we'll actually be working with when we start customizing our site, the scrolling nav there. If we go back, here in the fonts folder, we've got a glyphicons pack, and that's icons that we can use within our site, and we'll be doing that a little later on. I may decide to download Font Awesome because I prefer it. JavaScript. JavaScript is what makes things, actions happen on pages. For instance, the scrolling. That's all done with JavaScript here. Opening and closing models and things like that. It's all done with JavaScript here. We won't be editing much of this. In fact, I don't think we'll end up editing any of this at all. The index HTML file, you see it's HTML file. This is the one we'll be working on all the time. This is the file for our whole site. And if you double click on that one, it'll open up this in our browser, which is the bare bones of the site that we're going to be working on. License we covered last time. Always read the license. If you download a template, make sure you're okay to use it. And there's a README file as well that you can open with brackets and have a look at. So we're all good to go here. We checked the license. We can use this no problem at all. Well, first thing I'm actually going to do is I'm going to create one more folder. So I'm just creating a new folder. I'm going to call it IMG for images. You might want to spell that right, IMG. You can call yours whatever you want, but I suggest you call it the same as me if you want to follow along with the links we're going to build later on. Okay, so what we need to do first is open up our index HTML file in our brackets text editor software. And here we are. For those of you that don't have the brackets, I'll leave a link to it below. It's free software. Please download it and install it. It'll enable you to follow along a lot easier. So here's our index file. Basically, this is our whole site. This is the HTML for our whole site. We'll be building on this to create our site. And we'll just go through it. It's doc types HTML, the language is English, character set UTF-8, which is the Western character set. These are just viewport telling it to scale to the size of the screen, which makes it responsive. Meta name description, that's quite important there. In between these two inverted commas there, you want to put a description for your site. And for search purposes, a Google description really doesn't want to be more than about 160 characters. I'll just paste it in here. Let's just paste it in here. And this is what's going to show up in your Google or Bing search. I'll just show you if I bring up a browser. Here's a Google search. And see, my business is down here somewhere. This is what it's going to, the description, how it's going to appear in the Google search. So it's quite important, and you really want to do that one. The author there, you can put your own name or whoever you want to do. I'm going to add one more right here. Now, there's a lot of people that say nowadays Google doesn't really give keywords don't really count for much on Google. But I don't think it can do any harm. especially if people are using a different search engine. So if we put this in here, and all this code that we're writing today, don't worry about copying it, because I'll provide a PDF of what we're doing each day below the video, and you can link to it and download it and use it however you wish. So here's where you'd put your keywords. Let's say we're doing a site about photography. You can get your photography keywords and just paste them in there. Just comma separate them. You get the idea. I won't continue doing that. You don't want to overstuff it, but you can certainly put a few keywords in there, and you can also put your zip code or the location of your business as well. That doesn't hurt at all. Title. Here we see title. Here you want to put the title of your site, your business name, or whatever it is you're promoting. I'm just going to call mine One Page. And what this is, it's what's going to appear up the top of the search of your browser up here. For instance, scrolling nav, it says at the moment. Well, if I save this, just do Control S to save, or you can go up to File and hit Save, and then refresh this, you'll see that change to scrolling nav, or whatever it was I just put in, One Page Scrolling. There we are, One Page Scrolling. And the next thing we want to do, you see the Google little icon there, that's called a favicon or favicon. We want to put one in for our site, and that's just a little image. Usually it's 16 by 16 pixels. Nowadays with these iPads and retina ready things, you can put different ones in there, but I'm just going to put the one that will work on Google, Firefox and Explorer in there. So let's add our favicon. We created this little image folder just now, and now we're going to start to use it. I've got a little favicon that I created earlier. I'll just paste it in there. And all it is a, I just changed the view there so you can see it. All it is a 16 pics by 16 pics image. I've made it a little JPEG. I've called it Fav or Fave. So I put that in our image folder here that we created earlier. Now if we go back to our bracket software, all we need to do is put a link to that in there. So just after these keywords that we put there, telling it what it is. And again, I'll put a PDF of this below this thing so you can copy and paste it into yours should you want to do this. And this is the actual link to it. And it's prompting us here already, and it's in the image folder which we just created. And there it is. It's the favicon.jpg. And all images must have an alt tag. And what the alt tag does is it tells people that are hearing sight impaired, it'll actually read it out to them what it is. And also it's great, you can put keywords as alt tags as well to help site SEO if you need to. I'll just call it icon. And that's it. And that should link to our little favicon icon there. You see when we mouse over it, it's actually brought that thing up. It's made it look very blurry because it's bringing it up large. But if I just say that now, if you look up in the left hand corner here, you'll see a little dot by our index.html file. If you see that there, it usually means that you've not saved it. You've made a change and you've not saved it. So I'm going to hit Control S and save it. That goes away now. Now if we go back to our page and refresh, you keep your eye up here, that our little favicon should be there when we refresh. And there it is. Just to tell you what's going on, we've done the title there. Down below CSS Bootstrap, this is pulling in the style sheet for the Bootstrap, and it's styling our site with the default Bootstrap there. This is that scrolling nav.css file. It's pulling in and telling it to look in there for our styles, and we'll be updating that as we go along. And this is the end of the head tag. So none of this really shows on the site itself apart from this and that in the tab. Now here's the meat, here's the body, the start of the body where we're going to start to customize our site. Here's a nav bar that we can see there. So that will wrap it up for this video. It's been going on a bit too long now, but in the next one we'll actually start to style our nav bar, make it look good. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. If you're enjoying this, please subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.